Hi there, I'm Srikant from IBM. Organizations need to rapidly transform to keep up with competition, which includes modernizing mainframe-based apps. But how do you digitally transform highly secure transactions that require ultra-low latency? Example, cash deposits and withdrawals, insurance renewals, etc. By adopting a hybrid cloud with mainframe and AWS, enterprises can create a digital platform to support business transformation initiatives with resilient and secure transaction environment that is cost efficient as it scales. For example, new services offered through mobile apps can easily access and update customer information on the mainframe without significant changes and optimize the cost of running or extending applications. Now, open banking standards are changing the way banks offer services, enabling integration of value-added services offered by third-party fintechs. For example, payment initiation service allows direct payment through bank accounts. But what if the developer has little or no knowledge of mainframe apps? Introducing the IBM Z and Cloud Modernization Stack available on AWS, this solution can help you accelerate your application modernization journey. This demo illustrates how simple it is to add new features with APIs for enhancing a digital app that runs on AWS. With a little information, you can create an ZOS API in minutes and publish it, providing safe and secure access to query or update a mainframe application. What you see here is the flow of the domestic payment, the payment initiation API flow, and that is exactly what the demo scenario is. To demonstrate this, we have a shopping portal hosted on AWS that needs to query and update the mainframe application in real time using open banking APIs. With this, I would like to hand over the control to my colleague, Nikhil.
I'm Nikhil Thakkar. I'm really excited about working onto the IBM Z and Cloud Modernization Stack. In this demo, we will see how simple it is to use the ZOS Connect and ZOS Designer to create and publish the APIs which are mainframe backed. API developers are really not required to have the ZOS Connect and mainframe knowledge. With little knowledge, they can start creating the APIs in minutes and they can publish in minutes. So let's dive into the demo. Okay, so we start with component called is ZOS Connect, which is a part of IBM Z and Cloud Modernization Stack that allows API enablement. In this case, we are actually importing the payment initiation API specification that is provided by the standard body in ZOS Connect. Once imported, you will see a welcome page like this, where you can see all the different methods that you are required to implement. And the schema, it is nothing but a data model of the objects present in the request and response body. We can start with implementing one of these APIs, which is the domestic payment consent creation. It is a post request. Here we have to connect the API to the backend Kicks asset. For that, we need to create the ZOS asset that has all the information about the Kicks endpoint program and the COM area that is associated with the program. So we select the Kicks COM area program as the type of the backend and key in the program name. The language is COBOL and select the connection which we have. Now we have to do a request mapping. So basically mapping all the request parameters with the variables of the copybook. It is nothing but a mapping of the API specifications with the field specification. Once done, likewise, we can do the response mapping as well. Once all the request and response mapping is done, we can get the API testing. Now we have an API created to create a payment consent. So we will test it quickly with all the mandatory fields and the appropriate body, and that has all the required data. And click on execute. So we got a success response back with the response code 201, and that has the consent ID, which means a payment consent has been created.
Hi, I'm Brijesh Pandya. In the previous demo, you saw how an open banking RESTful API could be developed in a matter of minutes. These open banking RESTful APIs will interface with a backend app running on a mainframe, allowing you to conduct the safe and secure real-time transaction from your bank account. Now, let's take a closer look at the end-to-end flow of this scenario. The backend application, Bank Management Console, is displayed on the right-hand side of the screen, which demonstrates how the Open Banking REST API are utilized to process the request and provide the real-time updates. You can see in the Bank Management Console, there are $16,470 in his account. Let's use the shopping app to make the purchase. Look at those speakers. They cost $140. Let's put it in a shopping cart and check out. We are prepared to complete the payment, but we still need to provide the mailing address. When we choose a bank as our method of payment, a list of already authorized banks will appear. Here, the application directs the user to the payment gateway application. The bank is selection that draws the money directly from the customer's bank account. To complete the transaction, click on a pay. OTP handling would take place via the message you get on your mobile device. Let's observe how the Open Banking REST API works. We are just demonstrating the APIs in use by executing them sequentially. The order is successfully placed. Let's see what happened on the backend application. Through the Bank Management Console, we can see the account balance has reduced by $140. Now, check out the log first. We may observe the history of each Open Banking RESTful APIs we have only for the demonstration purpose. You can see that for the consent ID was generated, it was authorized. Additionally, there was an API for fund availability check that returned the status of the fund. And finally, the domestic payment is accepted and the status is all eventually changed and accepted, and we can see the settlement is finalized. That is the end of the demo. Thank you so much.